Welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, we will discuss how to design a multi-region disaster recovery strategy using AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery. The majority of my customers engaging in a migration journey to AWS already are using some sort of disaster recovery or high availability solution, spanning two or more data centers in different geographical locations. Frequently, that solution is based on virtualization or storage replication. With the engineering team being competent on operating that kind of solution, using a similar approach in AWS is identified as a requirement. Applications critical to the business, but not under active development, are targets of this particular resiliency need. To address this resiliency requirement, first you need to explore what are the options for disaster recovery of workloads in AWS. 1. Backup and restore. 2. Pilot light. 3. Warm standby. 4. Multi-site active-active. Typically, a storage replication-based DR solution can be categorized as a pilot light. The easiest way of implementing it on AWS is by leveraging the power of AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery, or DRS. DRS continuously replicates applications and database from any source into AWS using block-level replication of the underlying server file system. It is used for disaster recovery workloads consisting on applications and databases hosted on EC2. From the description, you probably already noticed some resemblance with features available in traditional data centers. Your engineering team will find the learning curve for DRS very gentle. Additionally, it is a very good match to provide resilience to black box applications we usually find in enterprise environments, where the code or the developer team is no longer available and the operations department only has access to the server hosting the app. DRS works by replicating from a local data center into AWS. An agent is installed in the operating system of your source servers. This agent connects to your replication server in the destination VPC replication subnet and executes a full sync of the disk detected in the server using continuous block-level replication. The replication instance stores a copy of the data as EBS volumes in the replication VPC. DR instances are launched in a separate recovery subnet. You can also configure the point-in-time feature that allows you to launch a recovery instance from EBS snapshots captured at a specific time in the past. Now, let's modify this architecture to design a multi-region deployment in AWS. The replication and recovery subnets configuration are kept the same. However, your source servers are now hosted in AWS in region A, while your DR destination is region B. A requirement is connectivity between the source VPC and the destination VPC. You can do it via AWS Transit Gateway or VPC peering. Be aware that data replication traffic uses port TCP 1500 and agent communicates with the DRS service over port 443. With these changes, you are able to fail over and fail back to a secondary region with as few clicks of the AWS console. However, bear in mind that DRS makes the failover process possible, but do not reroute traffic to the recovery infrastructure. You need to take care of that using Route 53 or your preferred DNS service. In this episode, we discuss how to implement a multi-region DR strategy based on storage replication using AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery. Check out the links below for more details. Thanks for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.